What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to a brand new episode on my channel. As always, I'm Jay, and guys, in honor of July 4th, I have finally watched Top Gun, starring Tom Cruise, which is one of the most quintessential classic awesome 80s movies. And guys, if you haven't seen it, just be forewarned that I am going to go into some spoilers as far as the plot details. So if you've lived under a rock like me and haven't seen this video up until this point, go watch it immediately and then come right back, because right now we're going to jump in and take the highway to the danger zone. So Top Gun was directed by the late Tony Scott and stars Tom Cruise as Pete Maverick Mitchell, a hotshot naval pilot who, along with his co-pilot Goose, end up going to the Top Gun Naval Academy in Miramar to show off their skills and become the best naval pilots, known as Top Guns, in the entirety of the fleet. And guys, the film is one of the quintessential 80s films, and of course it has so many great things, and the film has even been recognized as an important piece of cinematic history for all the things that it did inside of the film visually. And with all the aerial footage that you see in the beginning, it sets the tone for some more sequences later on in the film, which I was extremely amazed by, especially because of the age of this film. And throughout the course of the film, you kind of get a feel for how hot-headed and almost kind of against the grain that Maverick is. I mean, this dude's got a reputation for being cocky and, you know, being a little bit of a rule breaker as it is, and it clearly shows. It's peak 80s and it's peak Tom Cruise, to say the least. And while at the Top Gun Academy, it just so happens that Maverick actually tries to woo his instructor, aka Charlie, played by Kelly McGillis, who is stunning in this film. And of course, it would not be a good review of Top Gun if I didn't address the infamous volleyball scene, which is hilarious because it's just a bunch of guys with no shirts on, covered in baby oil, playing volleyball in the sun and the dirt. And this is totally a great summer movie, not just because of the action, not just because of the romance and everything, but because everyone is freaking sweating at every second of every waking moment, and you can feel the humidity coming off of the film itself. So needless to say, I really enjoyed Top Gun, and there are a few different reasons why I actually was unexpectedly surprised, and I liked it even more. One was the cast. I mean, again, Tom Cruise, pinnacle Tom Cruise, pinnacle 80s Tom Cruise, doing his thing, being a badass and being awesome. Then you have Goose, played by Anthony Edwards, who, growing up, I didn't even know about this movie. I just remember him from being in ER. Then you had freaking Tom Skerritt in the damn film as Viper, and he plays a little bit of a more integral part into being a mentor figure for Maverick, especially because in the film, there's a little backstory where Maverick's father actually served with Viper and everything. And then you get Val Kilmer playing Iceman. Now guys, one of the things that surprised the hell out of me was the fact that Val Kilmer actually didn't get much screen time in this, but what little screen time he got was pretty damn effective, and he was definitely a pain in the ass and a jerk to Maverick. And of course, like I said, Kelly McGillis, throwing off those cougar vibes, doing an awesome job. Now, some of the other things that I was very surprised at as far as casting was the appearance of Meg Ryan as Goose's wife. Who the hell knew Meg Ryan was going to be in this movie? Not I. And of course, my dude, Sam Fisher himself, Michael Ironside, as Jester. Alright now, so here's the big part of the film where everything kind of takes 180 and everything. You know, we're having a good time, we're doing some badass aerial dogfights and kind of trainings and everything, and then all of a sudden, in the middle of the film, in the midst of the awesomeness, with all the stuff and the camaraderie going on between the two, Goose is killed. Well, not killed, but he dies in a freak accident. And just the way that it happened, it was so unexpected, and you didn't really see how it was going to happen. Definitely something that elevated the way that this film was as far as quality and everything, which I really didn't expect, at least for me personally. Next up is the iconic soundtrack of this film. Guys, this soundtrack is fantastic for a lot of the hits that's going on in this. I mean, like I said, you got Danger Zone and Playing With The Boys by Kenny Loggins, who was a fantastic part of this. And then you have the theme song, which is so iconic. And yet, it feels kind of like the end credits song after you beat like a very satisfying trek under an old SNES game or something like that. But again, the cheese factor, the hilariosity of the whole nature of everything, it works so well, and you can't picture Top Gun with any other theme song or songs. The only thing that I have as a problem is this Take Your Breath Away song, which is overrated as hell. So all in all, guys, I enjoyed Top Gun, and it was a great film, and is one of the quintessential 80s films of all time. And guys, if you haven't ever seen it, you have to see it, especially since it's in the great mood of the summer, and it would be a fantastic film to watch this 4th of July. So guys, if you haven't watched it, go check it out. And if you are a fan of Tom Cruise movies, you'll enjoy it. If you're a fan of just fun popcorn action awesomeness with some cool visuals, I think that, again, this had so much hype and it lived up to it and then some. So guys, if you haven't already, go grab your copy of Top Gun, which was just released on 4K Blu-ray. I actually just got the Blu-ray digital version because I don't have a 4K player, and I don't really need a 4K player because, you know, Blu-ray looks fine to me. But guys, that's all the time that I have for today. So if you dug this video, thank you so much for watching it. Like, comment, subscribe, and if you are subscribed, hit that bell button. That way you never miss a moment of my content. But until next time, guys, as always, I'm Jay. So take care, and bye. I feel the need for speed. Talk to me, Goose. I was inverted. This is what I call a target-rich environment. That's classified. I could tell you, but then I'd have to kill you. That's right, Iceman. I am dangerous.